Hi, today's problem is a superconducting ring falling in a magnetic field under gravity. तो ये एक मैग्नेट है दिस इज ए वर्टिकल सिलिंड्रिकल मैग्नेट एंड दिस इज द axis of the magnet. The vertical direction is taken as the z axis and this is a superconducting ring of radius R naught, mass m and self inductance l. तो ये एक वर्टिकल सिलिंड्रिकल मैग्नेट है वर्टिकल डायरेक्शन z कोऑर्डिनेट देगा ये एक सुपर कंडक्टिंग रिंग है जिसका रेडियस है R naught, मास m है और सेल्फ इंडक्टेंस एल है द रिंग इज कोएक्सियल विद द मैग्नेट द रिंग इज कोएक्सियल विद मैग्नेट acceleration due to gravity g is acting in the downward direction The magnetic field lines of the bar magnet are like this. And the magnetic field B at any point can have two components. One is the radial component and the other one is the vertical component. The vertical component is given as B naught 1 minus alpha z, whereas the radial component is given as B naught beta r. Now what is r? R is distance of the point from the f. So this is about the magnetic field of the magnet. Now, initially, the ring is at rest the coordinates of center at t equal to 0 are r equal to 0 and z equal to 0. At t equal to 0, there is no current in the ring. Now the ring is released from ref. Now the ring is released from left. The ring will start falling downwards under gravity. You have to find z coordinate of center of ring as a function of time. Second, current in the ring as a function of time, and third, peak current in the ring. Peak current in the ring. Consider an observer like this, above the ring and looking downwards. As the ring will go down, this observer will see that the outward flux is increasing, and according to Faraday's law, he will find that a clockwise current is induced in the ring. So at any time t, the current in the ring will be like this. From here it will be coming outwards, and from here it will be going inwards. And let I be equal to the induced current in the ring at any time t. The flux in the ring can be written as Li, that is due to self-induction, plus due to the magnetic field along z axis, so dz into pi r naught square. So flux will be equal to Li plus V naught 1 minus alpha z multiplied by pi r naught square. Induced EMF is equal to minus d phi by dt. This is equal to I into R. Now, because the ring is superconducting, the resistance R will be 0. So, this will be equal to 0. This means the total EMF in the ring is always 0, and this implies that flux is constant. Now, flux is constant, then at t equal to 0, z is 0, I equal to 0, this implies that flux is equal to V naught into pi r naught square always. Therefore, you can write flux is equal to Li plus V naught 1 minus alpha z pi r naught square, and this is equal to V naught into pi r naught square. Now, if you simplify this, you will get I equal to V naught pi r naught square alpha z by L. So this is the current in terms of z coordinate. Now, as z is less than 0, therefore I is also less than 0, and negative I means the induced current in the ring will be clockwise as seen by this observer. Now, the force on the ring will be due to the radial component, and the force will be minus I 2 pi r naught into Br. The force will be minus I 2 pi r naught into B naught beta r, and putting the value of I, force will be minus B naught pi r naught square alpha z by L into 2 pi r naught multiplied by b naught beta r. Now, this is proportional to z, so I can write it as minus kz. Now, if you solve it, you will get the value of k. So, k is equal to V naught pi r naught square alpha z by L into 2 pi r naught into b naught beta r, and this z has to be removed. So the value of k is b naught pi r naught square alpha by l 2 pi r naught b naught beta r, and the magnetic force on the ring is in the upward direction. It is equal to minus kz. Another force which is acting on the ring is the gravitational force mg. Initially z is equal to 0, so there is a net downward force on the ring, and the ring starts moving downward. For equilibrium of the ring, minus kz minus mg equal to 0. This implies z equal to minus mg by k is the equilibrium position of ring. Now, because the net force on the ring is proportional to z, we can say the motion of the ring is SHM. Also, at z equal to 0, the ring is at rest, so it is an extreme position. Z equal to minus mg by k, the net force is 0, so this is the mean position, and the distance between extreme to mean is the amplitude. Again, z equal to minus 2 mg by k will be the other extreme position, and this depression will also be equal to amplitude. Now if I take another set of coordinates, z dash, where z dash is also vertical, but z dash equal to 0 at the mean position, so at the upper extreme position z dash will be mg by k, and at the lower extreme position z dash will be minus mg by k. From shifting of origin, it is also clear that z dash is equal to z plus mg by k. By using the equation for SHM, z dash is equal to mg by k cos omega t, where omega is equal to root k by m, and omega and k is known to us. K is known to us. Now putting z dash is equal to z plus mg by k equal to mg by k cos omega t, z is equal to minus mg by k 1 minus cos omega t. say the z coordinate as a function of time, it is always negative, and when cos omega t is 1, then it will attain a value of 0. So minus 2mg by k will be less than or equal to z, it will be less than or equal to 0. Now what about current? We know that current is B naught pi R naught square alpha z by L. So it is equal to B naught pi R naught square alpha pi L into z. Now z is minus mg by k 1 minus cos omega t. So putting the value of k in this, b naught pi r naught square alpha by l minus mg 1 minus cos omega t upon k. Now let me write the value of k. So k is equal to, if you remember, b naught beta r naught b naught pi r naught square alpha by l into 2 pi r naught. Now if you observe, these two terms will get cancelled out. So finally you will get current is equal to minus mg upon 2 pi r naught square b naught beta into 1 minus cos omega t. So this is the variation of current as a function of time. You can observe that it is always negative, that is clockwise. Now I is maximum when cos omega t equal to minus 1. Therefore the maximum value of I is, if this term will become 2, so it is mg upon pi r naught square b naught beta. So this is the maximum value of current which you can get. Thank you.